This area at the foot of the Himalayas is known for its high altitudes, impressive scenery, and now world-class wine. It all started with Maxence Dulou of the French luxury wine firm Moët Hennessy. For 4 years, he and his company searched far and wide in China for an ideal spot for cultivating a first-class red grape. They found it here in this remote area in China, located in the middle of three rivers, with moderate temperatures year-round.
Each terroir needs to be treated differently, so this is indeed very complicated. It is unique to our terroir.
And thus, the Chinese label Aoyun was born. It churns out 2,000 cases a year of a blend of Cabernet Sauvignon and Cabernet Franc.
Wine production worldwide is relatively in surplus. Therefore, creating new markets has become a strong desire of wine industries across the world.
Aoyun is offering a new choice amid China's burgeoning demand for wine. By 2020, China is expected to become the world's second largest wine-consuming country by value, surpassing France and the United Kingdom, and finishing just behind the United States.
In China, as people are becoming wealthier, they're focusing more on their spiritual happiness. They want more from life, and they know how to truly appreciate something instead of just its price tag.
Aoyun will have the challenge of convincing Chinese consumers to drink wine that's homegrown and sometimes criticized for being inconsistent. According to research firm Euromonitor, while consumption of imported wine has grown, domestic wine sales plunged for a fifth straight year.
I drink imported wine more often because I like the taste of different soils of foreign countries.
Indeed, there is a bad connotation to made in China, but everything we do with passion to make the best wine possible. And I think that we are one of the companies that are revamping made in China.
But Aoyun is making strides. At $300 a bottle, its wine is sold not just in China, but around the world.
A lot of our customers find this wine very interesting. After tasting it, they find it differs a lot from other Chinese red wines.
This wine quite surprising on the light of to our customers. They tasted this bottle blank, and most of them they think it's quite Bordeaux style of wine. Finally, they found this bottle is from China. All of them are quite excited. They're quite surprised about the quality of this bottle.
Putting this remote region on the map for even the most finicky wine connoisseurs. Francis Ko, CGTN.